To many, she's known as the wife of a politician who didn't stand by her man. She stood up for herself. Jenny Sanford is now divorced from her husband, the governor of South Carolina, who made headlines last year when he admitted to having an affair with a woman from Argentina. Her bestseller about that life-changing affair, Staying True, has now been updated and re-released, and she joins us this morning. It's good to have you back with us today.
Glad to be here.
And there's a new portion of the book. There's an afterword,
yes,
which you wrote over the summer before the release. And a couple of things that stood out to me. You said writing the book had been liberating, gratifying, successful, and fulfilling.
Yeah.
Talk to us about that a little bit.
Well, the process itself of writing, I literally had to go through old photo albums and my life. And it was actually very cathartic. And at the end of the day, I was able to come to a real peace about the notion that I believe I had been a good wife. And I gave my husband more chances really than he deserved. And so I was able to, through the writing of the book, to move on really with no regrets and with a real peace about me.
One of the things that people always tend to focus on in a divorce is when there are children involved. And you have four children. Your oldest just started college.
Yes.
How has this process been, not only when you were last here, we talked a little bit about the process of this very public divorce for you, but since then, you're writing about their lives, you're writing about things that change. How are they doing?
You know, they're doing great. And you hit the nail on the head when you said divorce is a process. You know, it doesn't end the day that the judge says you're divorced. And I did everything I could to stay married, to work on the family. But the decision was right for me. It might not be right for everybody, mm-hmm, but it was the right decision for me to divorce. But since that time, you know, you have to come up with new patterns of being with your ex-spouse. You know, the children and I live separately from him, but we do, you know, we get together on holidays sometimes or for birthdays and things like that. They're learning to set more boundaries with their dad. They're learning how to stand up for themselves, for example, when I'm not around, if they need something from him that he wouldn't necessarily be accustomed to giving them. It's been a good process. In many respects, we've all grown from it and have reached what I call a new normal. And it's been wonderful, I think, for all of us.
Which a lot of families can relate to, that new normal. You mentioned the boundaries, new boundaries for your children. What about new boundaries for yourself, especially because you are still seeing your ex-husband and you have to, every time you see him, I imagine, those memories come flooding back.
It's interesting. There are lots of little decisions you have to deal with when you divorce. Everything from boundaries, and when I say boundaries, you know, no, he can't just show up at the house when he feels like it just because it suits his schedule. You know, you have to learn to respect one another's space. Same thing with the children. If the children go to spend the weekend with him and one of them is sick, I'm teaching the boys to say, you know, Dad, this is what I need today, whereas Mom would normally have been there to help fill in that role.
So you're dating. What's that like?
I am starting to date, and I'm really having a great time meeting other men, and I'm not ready for a real relationship, if you will. It's too new. But I'm having a great time, actually. It's really fun. And you know, I'll know when the time is right. I'll know when the person's right. But it's too soon now. But it's actually, I'm having a great time.
How do your kids feel about that?
They're okay with it as long as they know that, you know, they really care that Mom is there and that nothing in their world is going to change again. They've been through some really tumultuous change. So as long as they see me home every day, you know, and know I'm not going anywhere, they're great with it.
And lastly, what happens after your ex-husband's governorship ends, which is very soon?
That's the big question. You know, the election is coming around the corner. He will technically be governor until January. And then we will have a whole nother process, you know, the boys and I, in terms of adjusting to what comes next for him. I don't know what he hasn't told me yet. You know, he might have something up his sleeve, but if he knows what he's going to do, he hasn't shared it with me. And so we're preparing for any host of possibilities. I mean, you know, he could live down the street. He could, you know, move to Argentina. She could move here. I don't know. So
a lot of unknowns. You said the only constant is change. So we'll be looking for that change. Jenny Sanford, really a pleasure to have you back with us this morning.
Thanks for having me.